Hi there, my name is Didi Kotlaba. I want to introduce the most important points for operating the DIRACT and DIRACT VOICE Avalanche transceivers. To turn the device on or off, press and hold the on-off button for 2 seconds. When turning it off, you must confirm by pressing the flag button. Use the toggle switch to switch between sending and searching. Otherwise, there's only one central control, the flag button. The DIRACT voice model comes with integrated voice navigation. With the exception of this search support, the DIRACT and DIRACT voice models are operated in exactly the same way. Briefly press the flag button to scroll through the language options. To select a language, press and hold the button for 2 seconds. Move more than 5 meters away from electronic and metal objects. Hold the device horizontally and turn it around clockwise. Then rotate it along the vertical axis. Hold it horizontally again and rotate it from this position around the horizontal axis. I highly recommend using the free ORTOVOX app. This way you can update the device software yourself, extend the warranty to 5 years, register your device, receive safety-related information, and with the app you can also change the settings, such as the device language, at a later time. Once turned on, the device will conduct a self-test and display the battery level. If the battery level is under 40%, charge the device using the charger provided. In group check mode, you test whether the other devices in the group are transmitting correctly. To activate it, press the flag button after turning on the device. The checking distance should be 1 meter. The distance between group members should be at least 3 meters. The device will show you when it finds a transmitter. Check whether the distance shown on the display roughly reflects the real distance to the transmitter. The device will let you know if there are too many transmitters within checking distance or if it identifies a defective transmitter. Send mode is the normal operating mode in the mountains. When the toggle switch is in the send position, send is displayed. To save battery, this display is hidden when the device is in darkness, but the device continues to transmit. Pressing a button reactivates the display. We recommend wearing it in the carrying system, into which the device is placed toggle switch first, with the display toward the body. The quick-release fastener and the waist strap buckle must be securely fastened. The safety loop must be attached to the device and the carabiner, and the carrying system must always be covered by a layer of clothing. If you're only wearing one layer of clothing, we recommend carrying it in a pocket that can be securely zipped up. Electronic, magnetic, and metal objects and equipment can interfere with avalanche transceivers. Typical sources of interference include smartphones, radio devices, action cameras, and sports watches. In send and standby mode, sources of interference must be kept at least 20 centimeters away from the device. In search mode, they must be kept at least 50 centimeters away. One part of the group search is using their avalanche transceivers. To activate search mode, flip the toggle switch to the search position. The other rescuers take on the tasks of making an emergency call and shoveling. To do this, they change to standby mode. In this mode, your own transmitting signal is temporarily suppressed so as not to interfere with the search. To activate standby mode, press the flag button when in send mode, and then flip the toggle switch up and back down again. In the case of a secondary avalanche, the device will automatically switch from search mode or standby mode into send mode after 2 minutes of limited movement. If no signals are displayed, search the avalanche deposit zone swiftly with the maximum search strip width displayed on the device. This adapts dynamically to the situation, for example, if there is strong external interference. Keep an eye out for partially buried victims and search in a group if possible. The distance from the edge of the avalanche deposit zone must be no more than half of the search strip width. When you first receive a signal, hold the device horizontally in front of you and run in the direction the arrow is pointing. Move quickly from first reception to approximately 10 meters away. The direction of your search only needs to be roughly right. Under 10 meters, move slowly and ensure you are searching in the exact direction the arrow is pointing. When the distance is less than 3 meters, the arrow will disappear. Move the device over the area, keeping close to the surface of the snow. Search slowly and precisely in a cross pattern until you reach the closest distance display. Mark this spot with an object so it can be probed. Once you have completed your search with a successful probe, you can hide this signal by flagging it. To do this, press the flag button. This signal will now be displayed at the bottom of the screen as a flag, and the search for the next closest signal begins. Even though our avalanche transceivers are intuitive and easy to operate, we recommend practicing emergency situations regularly and under professional instruction. Thank you for doing your bit to make the mountains safer. I wish you a safe and enjoyable mountain experience.